firm approaching the red corner, Alex Byrne.
Yeah,
we've met before, mate. It's not good if we met each other 10 times, I wouldn't remember it. You know what I mean?
This is Evolution of Combat 4 from the Maryhill Community Hall in Glasgow. You join us for our first K1 bout. This is Alex Byrne of East Kilbride MMA versus Jake Stark of Kaizen Academy in this under 68 kilogram K1 kickboxing competition. So Richard, we have a England versus Scotland competition
exactly.
today.
Hopefully it doesn't turn into me and you, mate. Avoid that. Nice inside low there.
Got Jake just kind of stalking forward and controlling the centre there. Alex, oh,
nice
Alex
one
swings.
There.
Good head movement though from Jake
no
there.
Just clinch.
Just avoiding that. Oh,
nice
jab. Nice little jab there.
He's going for that jab left quite a lot here, Jake. Exchange of low
nice
kicks
kick
there.
There from Jake. Oh, nice little
kick.
Shot from
Lovely
Alex.
Low kick from Alex. Jab and pull there, and another. He's staying on that leg. You know, Alex's coach, John Jameson, I believe, is a highly underrated striking coach. I really like John. He's a real good coach, so I think Alex is going to have some nice skills on the feet
Jake.
Here.
Doesn't capitalise on it with a counter, though, unfortunately.
Jake's kind of block him into the cage. If he can get him tired as the fight goes on, this might be a better strategy. But just now, I think Alex is finer.
Yeah,
nice
just,
roll
Alex
there.
Just seems to be chipping away at Jake with those low kicks. You can tell, you know, Alex is definitely the guy who has range on his side.
Nice to there.
Oh, nice
and
little,
a nice low.
Nice little flurry from
Hit
Jake.
Hit the knee there. I think that might be a bit of a sore foot for Jake.
Yeah, he's eating a couple of those little choppy leg kicks.
Mm-hmm.
Jake's there from Alex.
Jake's fought one of my teammates and one of the people on the card tonight.
Oh,
he might be dropped there. He's dropped.
Oh, he's been calling it.
Yep. There we go.
Nope.
He's not. Yeah, that'll be a 10 count there. I think he's okay there. I think he's fine. I think it was a bit of a flash and he's just kind of arsed it a little bit.
You can tell it's done. Doing a good job there for Jake's confidence now. He's being a bit
sure.
more aggressive.
He's starting to
there.
Open up a bit more. He was doing good with the stalking against the fence, but he wasn't actually doing much with it. I think that's going to give him a little bit more confidence now. Alex still staying on those low kicks, so they might start adding up further along in the fight.
Oh, Jake just swarming here.
Nice right hand left from Alex. Nice up. And another left hook. Lovely.
Both of them opening
good
up there towards the end of the round.
As per the rules, it will probably have a 10-8 there. For Jake due to him getting that 10 count there, but other than that, I'd say that was a very even round there.
Other than that moment, yeah. We had both of these fighters coming in off a loss of their previous previous performance. Jake has actually competed in Evolution of Combat before, losing against Dino Begg in Evolution of Combat 3. But winning before that in Evolution of Combat 2 against Jack Leckie, who will be making his MMA debut later on tonight.
You know, the thing is, I don't know what rule set Dino Begg and Luke competed in, but Dean Begg has been training longer than my grandfather has been alive. So
well, that was officially down as Dino Begg's debut because he's never done K1 before, but
well,
I was aware he competed in amateur MMA.
He's had more amateur MMA fights
in Cage Warriors,
yeah,
so yeah. He's
purple belt in jiu-jitsu, he's been training a long time, man. So fair dues to Jake having
and that went,
having
that went, the that went, that went through to decision as well. I mean,
that's fantastic. That's impressive, to be honest.
This is only Jake's third fight here. In any form of combat sport. We've seen in the previous performances of Jake
nice
in Evolution of Combat, he's come out kind of timid, and then he kind of builds power as he goes on.
Seems like a little bit of a dick kick.
Possibly a low blow there. We're gonna.
I think what Ari was just fixing his throwing guard. I find.
Swinging there
from
nice. Alex.
Checked him there, that left out. I think the thing with Alex though, he's not returning his hands to an intelligent position. He's throwing his hands
he's
out.
Leaving himself open
in
all these. And I think Jake's starting to get the hang of that now and just capitalise.
When he's lunging with that right hand, he's dropping his left at the same time. So I'm sure that's something John will be picking up on. So he'll be getting told in the corner. That was a nice exchange
right
of jabs
down the pipe there from
Very
Jake.
Nice. It's a nice low kick.
Nice
I would like to see
there.
More
just
low kicks,
Jake
more body kicks here. Like, if you watch the best K1 guys in the world, you guys like Giorgio Petrosian and stuff like that, it's all ending combos with lows and body kicks.
Oh,
I think
right, nice
well
overhand
right
there
hand.
from Alex.
And the under kick there. Add some more onto that from Alex.
Jake looking to counter off that. Alex swinging forward. Goes for a catch.
I would like to see some more kicks here. Body kicks, definitely. I think loads of inexperienced guys scared to throw the body kicks. You don't want to hit the elbows and hurt their shins, which I understand.
And there's also the risk of it, as we just saw a catch. Oh, Jake swarming forward there.
Jake has just turned it to Mike Tyson.
And now it's Alex's turn.
Oh, nice.
Now Jake shells up. Alex swinging at Jake.
Oh, and it
takes
looks like that. Yep, looks like Alex is starting to deplete here.
Yeah,
he's
that was
a bit tired.
That wasn't. Imagine wasn't wise to telegraph that so much.
I imagine both guys are blown a little bit, but
Alex is starting to show it a bit more. Jake forward again. looking to swarm Alex against the cage.
Nice there. As the K1 rule says, it's clinching one strike and break. So Alex got that one knee in there, 10 seconds left.
And Jake not wasting any time.
Oh, he's hit him. That's a big, beautiful
big
overhand. What
a fantastic way to end the round there for Alex Burns.
Lovely.
So phenomenal finish there.
I'd personally be giving that round a 10-9 to Alex. So that would take us still with Luke slightly edging it because of his,
Jake.
His win in the... Sorry, did I say Luke there? I'm absolutely tripping. Yeah, so that would take Jake still ahead on the scorecards in Mavericks, but round apiece.
Still marginal and definitely all to fight for in the final round. They both look like they're wearing this on their face, but Alex, like we said, does just look to be the slightly more fatigued.
Yeah, that little bit more tired for sure, I think. But you know what, this rule set, the rounds aren't too long anyway, do you know what I mean, in this
yeah, only got last K-1 2 minutes.
Yeah, exactly, so... I used to get to fight 2 minute rounds, that would have been absolutely delightful.
Yeah, I'm used to 6 or 7 at the moment, so
yeah,
this would be a gift.
So here, just about to kick off our third and final round between Alex and Jake.
Some good cross-border sportsmanship there from the Englishman and the Scotsman. Oh, and Jake straight... Nice little tee there.
I think John's maybe told Alex to kick a little bit. That right hand was big. Now it has turned into an MMA fight at boxing clubs.
Alex stands a lot like he wants to take Jake down.
Yeah. Yeah, I reckon John's maybe told Alex to get to work with those kicks a bit more. I think Jake's leg's starting to take a bit of wear there.
Jake swarming again. He's having another moment.
Alex he checked him with that right hand.
Both swinging now.
Yep.
Alex is letting Jake know that he's not phased.
And a nice roll
head movement
there.
Nice roll. Jake down the middle. Just glances over the top. Alex looking for the jab. And
nice,
Alex again
nice
looking
switch
to
of levels
Jake.
There and ending with the low kick. I think this is maybe going to be the thing that if this fight continues this way, we may edge it for Alex.
And Jake
and
takes
a
turn
here from Jake.
Let's see if he can get another knockdown like before.
Seem
to be almost taking turns at this point just to see who gets to...
Big right hand and finishing with a low kick.
Finishes it with the kick.
See, I think this is what's maybe going to edge this round here for Alex, is that he's ending his combinations with kicks. There's not much in the way of kicks, or not decent kicks anyway from Jake just now. He's very heavy with the hands.
Just to swing. He looks for his opening and then just goes mad trying to...
Lovely check in right hand, and then another nice low
Alex
kick
just
from
controlling
Alex.
The range. Oh,
he's
got several connections
up.
There. Against the cage again, look for the clinch. We don't have the time to waste time.
I think Alex just got hit in the throat there, which is very unpleasant.
And now Jake's following with the kick.
Well, Jack's going to need to check one of those,
Alex.
Right hand from Alex, big right hand.
Just kind of glanced over the top though, I don't think and now he's swarming. Alex swarming Jake, going for the body and the head, and we end, and Alex just collapses there.
Tired. Both. Alex and Jake, fantastic fight to start off the striking-based sports tonight. Finish with a grappling, and now we're into the striking, and now MMA after this, so that was awesome.
Towards the end especially, all pretense
that, that was
technique
cool.
Kind of went out the window, and we were just content to swing at each other.
For me, I think I'm going to give this fight just a split decision, probably, to Alex, but that was a fantastic contest. Great performance from both guys, definitely.
It's hard to tell, and I wouldn't really want to pick a side on this one. I mean, Jake had that fantastic first round knockdown.
Yeah, lovely.
Which is going to go heavily in his direction.
100%.
But then, like you mentioned, Alex had some very nice combinations, and he was always happy to end with one of those little chopping leg kicks, which Jake didn't really start to do until towards the end.
I think both guys here can be happy with some of the stuff they've done here and can leave with loads of stuff to work on in the gym. And that's what you want from a fight, in my opinion. K1 fight!
The judges' decisions are in. It is a unanimous decision that this K1 contest has a draw! So please give your applause going for Alex Burns!
Very fair decision there.
Oh,
I imagine it's been a 10-8 in the first round and for Jake, and then a 10-9 for the other two rounds for Alex. So that was a fantastic fight. Both guys can be really happy with that result.